baseball from the Big Apple. We're at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Milwaukee Brewers and the New York Mets. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next. Now at the plate here is Colton Wong. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit sharply toward the right side.
Conforto
is there, one away. Digging in now for the Brewers, Willie Adames. One out, nobody on. Hit out toward second. And that's the second out. Next to hit, Christian Yelich. Two out, nobody on. Now a sinker's low off the outside corner. Two balls and a strike. All even now, 2-2. Hit hard on the ground to third. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And the recovery will not be in time at first, and the inning will continue following the infield single.
The right fielder, obviously.
In now, Abisail Garcia. Right down the chute that time, 1-2.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that.
But we'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Ready now is Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 2-1 is taken for strike two.
Talk about challenging a guy. He offered up two in a row right down the chute, and the batter didn't even flinch. Gotta wonder what he was looking for.
Kane is after it. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Digging in will be Brandon Nimmo. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Up next, Francisco Lindor. His career numbers in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Popped him up. Escobar is under it. And that ends the inning. New inning set to get underway, and next to hit is the catcher, Narvaez. Now the 2-1 pitch. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. Scooped up on the first, and there's one gone here to start the second. So one down, no one aboard, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. Here comes the 1-2. No score here as we play inning number two. And that one got a piece of him. Daniel Vogelback's next.
The first baseman, Daniel Vogelback.
1-1. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, and that finds its way through for a base hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. The relay, and it's in time. He's out at second as a good relay gets him. At the plate now, Lorenzo Cain. This one skied out toward right.
Conforto
is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Last last half of the second set to go. And here comes the first baseman, Pete Alonso. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. Digging in next, Michael Conforto. In his career versus this pitcher, he's a .333 hitter. Shoots this one over to first. One there. On to first, and they get the double play. So the base is empty now after the double play. And that'll bring in the second baseman, Javier Baez. 1-1. Bottom of the second here with no score. Two and two.
Got a pitch to the ballpark's dimensions right here. Love the execution of that pitch down in the zone. Got to keep the ball in the yard.
And it's fouled away. The 2-2 one more time.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Bases are empty here with two men out. Full count still.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
Full count, here it comes. And the 11th pitch is the charm as he strikes him out to end the inning. Set to begin the third inning in this one. 1-1. On the ground is second for Baez. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Next for Milwaukee, Colton Wong. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
Lifted down the line and left. And that's in there. Base hit. Into the box now. Willie Adames. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Wong stands at first with one out. Just hung in there on that one.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now. 3-2. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. There's one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. For the last half of the inning, and next it'll be the outfielder Jeff McNeil. Now the 2-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Oh, he's got that beautiful 12-6 curveball, doesn't he? It's part of what makes him as good as he is, and he has a lot of confidence in it. He'll even throw it behind the count at times.
2-2 is a changeup that misses. 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Jeff McNeil is set backing to begin the bottom of the third. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Mets are still looking for their first hit of the ball game. Line drive to left. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Mets.
No pitcher.
So now to the plate, Marcus Stroman. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1. And he can't get the bunt down here, so it goes to 2-2.
He's going to be looking down at the third base coach right now, hoping he takes this bunt sign off. It's just a lost art in today's game.
3-2, full count. Bit of a surprise here as he's going to try to lay one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
Third baseman, number one.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And the switch hitter, Jonathan Villar, will be the next to bat. The 2-2. Got him swinging. Made him chase outside the zone that time, and that puts an end to the inning. Set for the start of the inning, and up next, the sweet swinging left-handed hitting outfielder Christian Yelich.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
1-2.
1-2 for Christian Yelich. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. No one on with one down. That'll bring up Abisaiu Garcia. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now. Stepping in once again is Omar Narvaez, grounded out in his last at bat. Caught off at the plate as it's chopped foul. The 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pot commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Running hard, he's digging for second. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double. At the plate, Eduardo Escobar. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Swing and a ground ball to third. Reined in. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. So now here is Brandon Nimmo, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Changeup, called strike three as he rolls his eyes at the call. One away.
Now batting.
Next up, Francisco Lindor flew out last time up.
Lindor.
Hit down the third baseline. Here comes the 1-2.
Nope.
No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Struck him out. So two are gone in the Mets half of the fourth, and up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. Now the 1-1 pitch. Fouled away.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. And stepping in, Daniel Vogelbach. He was cut down at second, attempting to stretch a base hit his first time through.
Yeah, fellas, not sure if he got the go-ahead from his base coach or not. Can't believe he did, but it looked like he was running in mud right there.
Fouled off. Ready with another 2-2. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down. In now is Lorenzo Cain. He's 0 for 1 thus far. A 1-1 home. No runs, four hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two. Next, here is Brandon Woodruff. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Well, right back at him, and it hit him. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first, and that'll put an end to the inning. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Michael Conforto. Here's the 1-1. Right side, defense aligned perfectly. Taken in by Wong. Throw on to first in time, one away. One out, bases empty. And into back next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So next to hit is Jeff McNeil, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. A 1-1. Two out, nobody on. And another foul ball. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time.
Three ball.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count. And he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
Count still full. 3-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And that misses ball four, and now the Mets have themselves a two-out base runner. Next up from New York, James McCann, man at first after the two-out walk. Here comes the 1-2. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Coming in on it is Kane. He can't get to it. This one's down. Standing in now, Marcus Stroman. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
And it's fouled away. He's set, the payoff pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring up Colton Wong. Runs up and gets this one down. Throw to first will get him as they pounce on it quickly to snuff out the bunt attempt. Stepping up is Willy Adames. Couple of ground outs on his batting line in two trips so far. Brewers shortstop ahead with a 3-1 count.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Line drive snagged on a short hop. On to first, and there were two down. Next to dig in, Christian Yelich. He's 1 for 2 in this one. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch.
The count is 1-2.
Ground ball right side. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar. Sent on the ground out to second. Wong has it, and there's one down now. One away now for the Mets in the sixth, and ready to bat next, the Wyoming native Brandon Nimmo. 1-1. That ball's headed for the gap in left center. He's got a base hit, possibly more. He'll get it into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two base hit.
Now batting, shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
Stepping in now, Francisco Lindor. Three ball, one strike count to the Mets shortstop. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Here comes the payoff pitch, and here's a ball hit in the air. Garcia has a read on it, makes the play, and there are two gone now. Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso, runner in scoring position with two gone. Inside here with the hard stuff, and it's 2-1 now. And with just 5 2/3 innings under his belt, he's about to hit the century mark in his pitch count now.
Yeah, Matty V, and the way baseball is played these days, it's about 6 innings or 100 heaves, and you're pretty much looking for that bullpen. And Devo right now, this guy's.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. Throw into second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. Into the box, Michael Conforto. This is on the ground over the first. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll bring up Abisail Garcia. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
You see there, the pitch count is up to 88. And at this point in the game, that's a good place to be. So I think we'll see him stay out there for at least a little while longer.
The 2-2 one more time. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
Now that.
Next to hit is Narvaez. He doubled his last time through.
And he's got to build off that last AP. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
But the shortstop won't have far to go to haul this one in, and there are two away. So here's Eduardo Escobar. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Three balls and two strikes to Eduardo Escobar.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Hit back toward the mound. That's through for a base hit, and he's 1-for-2 now.
Now back, the first baseman,
in now, Daniel Vogelbach. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And he goes the other way with it. High and deep down the left field line. Gone! A two-run shot that gives them the lead. Your Seth Lugo will get the ball here now as he looks to get the final man out in the top of the seventh.
Number 67. Seth Lugo.
Into the box now. Lorenzo Cain. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2.
fastball here misses low, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Hunter Strickland will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Jackie Bradley Jr. is into the ball game as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Hit hard up the middle. Wong to his right. He's got it. And there's one away. Next for the Mets, Jeff McNeil. It was a walk in his last trip. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Lunging at a changeup that time, and he pops it up near second. And this is taken in for the second out. So stepping in is James McCann. Two base hits, both singles to this point. Two out, nobody on. Taken, but that catches the inside part of the plate. Two and two to the Mets catcher.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Popped him up. Narvaez over to his left. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Here's Jackie Bradley now, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Here's Colton Wong now. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 1-1.
The count is 1-2.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Next to stand in is Willy Adames. Past matchups against Seth Lugo. He's a 333 hitter. Smoke on the ground left side. And that's through for a hit.
The left fielder, number 22, 15, Yelich.
At the plate now, Christian Yelich. Hit out towards second. Baez fields it cleanly. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Your Brad Boxberger is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Luis Guillorme will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. Doesn't hit the target. It's ball three.
Down by a run, your guy needs to get on any way he can. His mentality has to be to shrink the strike zone to like the size of the soup can. No reason to swing at a pitcher's pitch.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. Digging in, the switch hitter, Jonathan Villar, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
Yeah, this is his power side, Matt. He definitely quite a bit more pop in his bat swinging left-handed.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. One and two now. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. From from the belt, the pitch. Peraza on at first, nobody out. On a good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second time today. So a runner at first now with one away, and ready to bat next, the Wyoming native Brandon Nimmo. Quick check on that tying run at first. A 1-1.
Ball two. That's a ball.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
The 3-1 pitch. Count remains full. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And it's a foul ball. The next 3-2. Pulled toward right center field. Garcia has a read on it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. Now it'll be Francisco Lindor. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Fouled away.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder,
Avisail Garcia.
1-1, here it is. And now a good slider that doesn't quite catch the zone. It's 2-1 now.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
The 2-2. Now a swing as he stays alive as this is fouled back right off the catcher's arm. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Hits this one hard the other way. And that is in the right field, so the leadoff man's aboard here to kick off the ninth. So now to the plate, Omar Narvaez. Another 1-2 delivery.
I got to count 2-2.
Nobody out, runner on first. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Omar Narvaez becomes the first out in the ninth inning. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Now at the plate, Daniel Vogelbach, and he's coming off a two-run homer his last time around. 3-2 pitch, and a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four, and as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. Moves to a ball and two strikes now. And again, another foul ball.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Here's the 1-2. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The 2-2. Down the first baseline. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Might have gone after ball four there as this one's fouled away off to the right. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Josh Hader comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 71.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And next will be the imposing power bat, Pete Alonso. Three and two.
Wow, that was a pretty good two-strike slider right there. I think that would fool them, and the umpire, too.
Good battle. Count remains full. Now a ground ball and a chance for Radames is short. On to first, and that is a huge out to start the bottom of the ninth. Next, it'll be Michael Conforto. Lifetime in this matchup. He's 1-for-4. Fouled off. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2. Javier Baez is on deck. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
Second baseman.
The 2-1 home is laid off up for ball number three.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk it, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
Count full, three balls and two strikes. The Mets down to their final strike. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Man, we were treated to a nice pitcher's duel in this one. Both starters throwing strikes. They worked deep, and both were in command of the game. It really came down to a few key at-bats. This was a fun game to watch.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The Milwaukee Brewers jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Brandon Woodruff earns the victory on the mound. Marcus Stroman pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line.